I've got a special guest with me. His name is Congressman Tom MacArthur. He is a congressman in New Jersey, and he had the opportunity, and we talked about this earlier, and of course I want to get his opinion on weighing in on this this new law about searching, but he had an opportunity to sit down with Shanine Allen. As you know, she was the subject of, she was facing 11 years in prison for her legal right to carry in Pennsylvania because she crossed the line and drove into New Jersey. She ended up with a pardon from Governor Christie. She is one of the victims of these draconian laws in New Jersey that hurt sometimes the people they're intending to help. Congressman MacArthur, welcome to New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. How are you today?
I'm doing great. I appreciate your patience as we you know, a subject like this gets people really up in arms. And I really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us. I wanted to get your perspective. First, how is Shanine Allen doing, and is there a long road ahead for her?
Well, there's certainly a road ahead. And, you know, I think what's unfortunate is that she was pardoned back in April, as you mentioned, by Governor Christie. But she spent 45 days in jail. This is a mother of two young children. And she has not yet had her record expunged, which means that it's very difficult for her to get employment. In fact, she's been unable to, because even though she has pardon, she still has this criminal record outstanding. So this is really an unfortunate situation, and that's why she came to see me, and we ended up sitting down and talking about what I might be able to do to help her.
So how are you able to help her? I think that for our listeners, they don't necessarily, I didn't know that. I assumed when a pardon comes down, that's it. It wipes everything out. Is it just a matter of time, or is it some bureaucratic snafu, which wouldn't surprise me?
I unfortunately, it may be the latter. It's time and it's a process, Bill. And the process includes signatures from various people. And that's, you know, I don't think anyone is intending at this point for her to be in this situation, but she is, and we need to try to help. Because as you mentioned at the very beginning, this is a woman who was robbed twice in Philadelphia, got a permit to carry, and came across the Jersey line not realizing that she wasn't supposed to be carrying in New Jersey. She's the one who brought it to the officer's attention.
Right.
It's really an unfair consequence for her, and she still continues to live through it.
Well, and you have to let us know. I mean, I will certainly be on Twitter and on Facebook. If there's something, if she's doing something that she's got a Facebook page or a website or something where our listeners can help, I want to get the word out, because I think she is absolutely an unfortunate victim of these laws, not to mention an overzealous prosecutor who essentially gave a pass to Ray Rice. You know, yes. Right in the same time period.
Yes, and ultimately, that's I think that's what gave this attention and brought it to the light of day, and ultimately may have helped her to get pardoned. And you know, because it became obvious there was an injustice
right.
here.
Congressman, real quick, you have a bill before Congress that would allow for reciprocity. If someone has a right to carry in another state, like Shanine, it would be legal in New Jersey. You've got a majority in Congress. Is there any chance that a bill like that passes and it might help temper some of the, you know, the emotion that's out there on this latest ruling of the Supreme Court that cops can search your car without a warrant? Something like this, it sounds like would be helpful, but is there any chance that that goes anywhere?
Well, I co-sponsored the Concealed Carry Reciprocity Act of 2015. It goes only so far in terms of Shanine Allen. What it would do is, if you have a right to carry in one state, it would allow you to automatically carry in another state that allowed concealed carry. So it would be, you'd still have to obey the laws of that state you go into, but it would be like a driver's license where you can cross state lines, and as long as you obey the laws of that state, you're allowed to operate there. The problem is New Jersey doesn't allow concealed carry, so it wouldn't have solved her problem. But, Bill, I see a lot of this as a process where you move the ball forward. I think we need to do the things we can do to protect people's constitutional right to protect themselves and their family. without relying on the state. And this is a start. I think it's a move in the right direction.
You know what, Congressman? I love it. I respect you for doing it. It can be unpopular, but sometimes common sense has just got to prevail. Now, I don't have a lot of time left, but I have to ask you, did you meet the Pope yesterday? Or were you in the room when he walked in? What was that like?
I was. It was awesome. Yeah. You know, I really admire his faith, his compassion for regular people is so obvious, and you could see it. You know, he comes alive when he's with crowds of not lawmakers, but the people on the street, and he certainly came alive with us too. But he's a real man of the people, and I admire him for it. It was a tremendous honor to be there. First time Pope has ever addressed a joint session of Congress, and it was his first to visit the United States. So it was really an historic day.
That's pretty. Now, I just have to ask, did you take a selfie with him? Did you like turn around as he was speaking?
No, I didn't take a selfie. Although I did see people doing that.
But, I'm sure they did. Congressman Tom MacArthur, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Looking forward to having you back real soon.